Ladies and gentlemen, this formally launches and opens the dissemination of our public investment financing strategy.
During the 2020-2021 financial year, domestic debt stood at 22.96 trillion shillings, indicating an increase from 17.38 trillion shillings in December 2019.
So the INF and the PIFS initiatives will enable Uganda to attain a long-term fiscal sustainability in as far as financing government programs and projects.
This mainly consisted of short-term and long-term borrowing externally and direct commercial bank borrowing from the domestic markets.
We think that there are options out there. There are partners and even the private sector who are ready to partner with government to implement some of the commercially viable projects.
Speaking during the launch of the Public Investment Financing Strategy today in Kampala, the Minister of Finance, Matia Kasaija, said he is currently uncomfortable and very tired of borrowing, expressing an urgent need by the government to draw new strategies of raising funds locally to run government programs.
Thank you for showing us that so much can be done without borrowing. Me, I'm tired of borrowing, by the way, let me tell you the truth. I'm very tired of borrowing. We must look for different ways on how we can raise funds to develop Uganda apart from borrowing.
The development cost of financing on all government programs is estimated at 411.7 trillion shillings. The government budget has always been close to 49 trillion shillings, hence a financing gap of 33 trillion.
When we increase the tax, somebody is pressurized, another one is happy. There is no policy you will develop and think that it will please everybody. Impossible. There is no government regulation that will put in place and it will please everybody.
Although borrowing and grants have served Uganda, Kasaija says they are not sufficient. He's however optimistic that the new strategy unveiled today, if fully implemented, will help to address this long-time challenge.
This financing plan is a priority for government. I therefore urge every Ugandan individual, development partner, private sector player, ministry, department and the agency to peruse the strategy so that you can participate in financing for development of our country, Uganda.
The acting director in charge of debt and cash policy at the Ministry of Finance, Maurice Wanyera, called for widening of the tax base, bringing the private sector on board and also tapping into the savers funds in order to raise funds locally.
Aligning resources to the right investment. That is what it is all about. And then bringing on board the private sector and other interested stakeholders and even small savers to support the implementation of the National Development Plan.
In 2015, during the third United Nations International Conference, world leaders agreed upon a new global structure for financing the 2030 Agenda in Sustainable Development Goals, which required countries to develop specific financing strategies to mobilize additional finance away from borrowing. Report by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.